Hello everyone, my name is Zachary Hauptmann, and my Archives Honors Project will be discussing the time the 19th Iowa Infantry Regiment were prisoners of war during the American Civil War. And we're going to look at that through the perspective of a man named William Bragg. I don't have enough time to go through all 50 pages worth of content, so I'll give some highlights from what Bragg experienced. The reason I chose this is because when most people hear the term POW, they usually think of World War II, for good reason. And I wanted to look at a different era of POWs and see how they compared. I also talk about the process that I went through briefly. So we'll get some general information out of the way. The 19th Regiment was, or were, imprisoned for roughly 10 months, and then they were exchanged with the Union. They spent most of their time at Camp Tyler, and that is in the eastern part of Texas. They were captured in Louisiana, and I thought it was interesting. They were sent out to bait a Confederate general, and unfortunately, he took the bait, and he also brought 5,000 men with him. Something that's rather remarkable is that the 19th Regiment and the other Union regiments that were with them managed to hold him off for roughly 2 hours, but obviously they were captured at some point, and they were taken about 300 miles to Camp Ford. So one main thing I wanted to get across were the interactions between Union and Confederate soldiers. And I'll just give a couple examples. I was advised to do this. So the first one is why I have this. This happened when they were first handed off to a man named Captain Alford, and he would often make the prisoners run for over 20 miles, and anyone that was lagging behind or tried to take a break, he would grab a lasso and he would tie it around their neck, and basically he would drag them for several miles. So now we don't need that anymore. The other one, this one's more positive. This was near the end of their imprisonment, and they met these Confederate soldiers who were very nice to them. And it turns out that was because they had been at the siege of Vicksburg, and the 19th Iowa had actually given them food, and so they were basically repaying them for that. One thing Bragg talked about was Yankee ingenuity, or what he called Yankee ingenuity, and it was basically, I'm just going to give a couple examples. They mainly showed up as escape attempts. Two men from the regiment hid in these carts that basically took filth out of the prison camps. So basically, these two soldiers escaped through 18th century dump trucks. And another guy played dead, and he was buried in a shallow grave. And then he escaped through there. So I just wanted to bring those two up. This guy is Dungan, James Dungan. He has a whole thing in the archives, but I can't talk about him. I only brought him because I wanted to show the condition the clothes were in most of the time, because they were exposed to the elements for months on end, so their clothes were usually torn quite a bit. And these are from the digital Library of America, I believe. And they are basically the enlistment and dischargement sort of little slips that a soldier was given. And that one is William Bragg. That's his private sergeant. And that one's Dungan. And that's his corporal and sergeant. So I appreciate you taking the time to listen to this. And that's just for Rachel. So I hope you have a good day. And that's all.